the threshing floor of God. When David wanted to do a census, Joab said to him, what you are doing is wrong. But you give a muti mukreke ya muti. But you are saying a root. But you give a muti mukreke ya muti. But you are saying a But you give a muti. And when God wants to use his people, he will use them whatever 50, whatever 10, whatever 30. When people see us, the kreke ni ni kanam kono. Resela kala mo ni tulo. Barabatsani kreke ki kreke ya muti. Barabela muti. They don't care how many we are. It is God and his mission. And Joab told him, and what you're doing is wrong. You cannot do that. But what you want to do? Hasn't the Lord been fighting for us all the time? To appoint more than God. But David would have noticed. No problem. No, he would have none of it. He would not listen. As a teenager, Joab. Amen. When it offended the Lord, and David saw what people are dying, and the angel of the Lord is still moving, he realized now the extent of the damage he did relay. Utoma ubona or kitirile poshoho. Utoma ubona or muliko ku dirile. And a muliko su chaba sesitrencha kin nakagaro usona. Kin naki lembaya babane. Asibona. Bonai no baba tuwabadiwa. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. And then he goes and pleads to God for mercy. Arapela mutimba mutimu kame. Mutimu tsame. For what I have done. Amen. And God gives him an instruction. God says to him, there is a place that you must go to David. There is a searching, a threshing floor, ya aruna. Somewhere in the Bible says the threshing floor, ya ora. It's the same thing. Amen. There is a threshing floor. Why God commands him to go. God says you go to that threshing floor and you go and you build an altar for God. Amen. What is a threshing floor? A threshing floor is a place of separation. A threshing floor, a place where things which are not needed are identified and they are disposed of. And things which are needed are gathered. A threshing floor is known to farmers. When the farmers separate the corn from the seed. But you feel a little bit. On a flat surface, it can be a place like this. It's called the threshing floor because that is where the process of separation takes place. Give over separate and the seed from the corn horn. Amen. They can do it by machine or they can do it by hands. Amen. What did God do to David? God sent David on a place of separation. He sent him to a threshing floor. Amen. God wanted to forgive David. God wanted to save Israel. But when he looked at David, there were issues. You see, when we are called into salvation, You can get into salvation. Well, almost spiritual, yes, you pray, but your pride is almost simultaneously with your prayer life. Do you get what I'm saying? But your wickedness, at the same rate that your prayer life is growing, you need to get to a place of separation. There comes a point in your life where you must get to the threshing floor where God wants to deal with these things. You see, God wants to take you somewhere, but there is a place that you must get to. That place is called the threshing floor of God, where the impure must be cleaned out. God referred David to the threshing floor because he wanted to deal with the pride inside of him. He wanted to deal with the issues character ya David. Even I cannot claim to be perfect. There are things within myself that I am dealing with. There are things within your own life that you are dealing with. There is no one who is all imperfect. Mother, we must go to the threshing floor of God. When we realize that there is something wrong in us, we go to the threshing place of God. And we say, that which you don't need for your work, it is for the carabo for work. You will show God in your cage. You will send a carim to work. It could have been a hole. God, it has to show us what our casting. That is exactly what happened to David. Many of us in the church, we've got weaknesses, we've got problems, we know. Our character deficiencies, there are things that we are doing, there are things that are in us, and we need to get rid of them. There is a threshing floor, a place of separation that God is calling you to. All of us, you must get to that level. You will grow, yes, spiritually. From your days of infancy, you will grow, but you need to grow to that level where you start realizing, this thing is not like Christ. You must be willing to sacrifice yourself. There are things that you must let go of in your life. You can only happen at the threshing floor of God. They can only happen at a place of separation. You must be willing to get to a place of separation in your life. Amen. Hallelujah. When David was achieving a lot of things, many of God's children, when they are in the church and they are doing well and they are serving God, one year or a tithe, for example. Then the Satan walk out when now you know what? They can't survive without tithe. When I'm not going to sit in this church, how can I when I come to Greek? Because when they cannot do without you, while worship from worship team, they cannot do without you. But as Kono Hala Silo, so when I was still a car, be it good, be it bad. Satan, now what I'm going over, you are indisposable, no medical one to go. But God gave you the grace to put him first. God gave you the grace. It was not the intention of God. It was the intention of God. Today, my God, I trust. It is not because it is not because not special. It is because you enabled me. You gave me the grace. It is not because I am selected than everybody. It is not because I can sing better than anybody else. It is because you, my God, have poured into me and you are using me for your kingdom. Hallelujah. Until you get to the threshing floor, you will not go a process of separation. You get to the threshing floor. How? David looked at what was happening around him and he realized, but I have erred. Kissing any chamberlain. You see, when you look around your life, when I want to say, when you must be the one to look around you and to identify where is everything going right. And when you see things are going wrong, you start looking to God and asking him, Mutimu, am I doing right by you? Have I developed tendencies? Have I developed a way of thinking that is not consistent with your grace? Have I developed a way or a sense of myself that is not consistent? No way, and then you get to the threshing floor. David got to a threshing floor. It was a difficult thing for a king to do, because the king is above everybody in the land. But for him to get to a threshing floor of a subject whom he rules, let us acknowledge if we are not working with God and we have issues. Be the one, the first one to say, "Can I have a problem?" If it is a problem, be the one to say, "Can I have a problem?" If you have a problem, be the first one to acknowledge your problem, your deficiencies. Because if you are not acknowledging it, you'll never reach the place of separation. You'll never reach that place where God wants that thing out of your life. You'll continue to lie to yourself. Only to find God is not pleased with him. God wanted to correct the conduct of David. God pointed out some things on the threshing floor. We are all of us perfect. We think we can do it on our own. But God will show you when you have stepped out of line. When God shows you, acknowledge. God is calling for separation. Every time you do something, your spirit tells you, you lie to yourself until you get to that place where you admit who you are and that you need help. God will never help you. You will never go through the process of separation. Jacob, or in the book of Genesis, it is not that they didn't know who he was. God knew exactly who Jacob was. But God wanted something. Jacob, you have been living a lie of deceit. Jacob, you have been living because of your way of life. You took away the birthright of your brother. You stole it. You took away and stole from other people. You were lying. You were a deceitful person. Who are you, Jacob? Are you willing to face and say, "I am Jacob. I am a sinner. I am not right before you, my God"? God will never change your name. Jacob found himself at the river of Jabbok. He had to face who he was. He had to face the problems. Not other people. Problems. He had to face who he was. He was Jacob. And God had promised him abundance of a nation, as numerous as the sand, that could not be counted. But Jacob had to die. And Israel had to arise. It was at the river Jabbok that God asked him, "Who are you? Oman, when I come and bela bela. Oman, you've got to go to a place of separation where the old you dies to the things of the world. Where the old you dies to the things. Chane fasi, chane who can correct ayayaga. Chilo chane who can bupiro bubagao. You've got to go to that place where you separate from them. Where God stands with you and purifies you and cleans you up and makes you his child. Until you get to that place, there will never be an Israel arising out of you. Because God cannot use a deceitful sample. God cannot use a gossiping sample. God cannot use a lying sample. He wants them pure. Hallelujah. God wants a separation in our life. Can only happen at the threshing floor. At the threshing floor, God will beat some things out of our lives. And the better will need a karama pillow arena. So that we can start making progress, karam shuwaga. So that we can start making progress, karam picho yaga. He is calling each and every one of us to a separation, karama pillow arena. He is calling us. Amen. A separation calls for confrontation. If you are not willing to face who you are, you will never create truth. Amen. You you have to confront your problems. Problem, then you have to confront that as a problem. If you have a problem, then you've got to confront that as a problem and deal with it at the threshing floor. Amen. At the threshing floor. Hallelujah. If you don't, you are delaying yourself, your own calling, your own purpose, your own journey, limuti. Amen. More young one, limuti. Hallelujah. The figure be eliminated. And would you have to take a sage? Would you have something more? It is a Porsche. How many of us, including us pastors, can say, would you have wronged? How many of us, including the Nabarut, can say, you know what? So how many of us? How many? Because in pride, in Tibela or Legend portion to Melemutima are correct. We don't want to be corrected. Few pastors you can tell them or Ruti Bam Ruti. Hey, two garman in our heart. Renya can pray singers around us. We want people around us who will back up a because they force us to look at ourselves. Bless you. Be careful who you surround yourself with. Be careful who you surround yourself with. The funny thing, Yori, when David went and humbled himself before God, God pointed him to the threshing floor. It was not only a place of separation of what he had developed, the sense of pride that he had gotten. It was also a place of answers. The same place where God wants to separate. It is also a place of blessings where God will start to bless your life. Let me tell you the funny thing about God is he meets you at your point of need. When you need him the most, when you acknowledge what you talk about, when you are true to yourself and your weaknesses and your inabilities, that is when God shows up with his own strength and starts doing great and wondrous things. But when you are forever strong and lying and deceiving yourself as your own abilities, God doesn't show up. As long as you cage, come on, make your own. Now can do this. Now you saw. Hang out. God will never arrive. He will never show you and fill you up. When David asked God for forgiveness at the threshing floor, God said to him, go and build me an altar. What was God saying? He referred him to a place of separation. And he said to him, Honamo Tafida. Go and build me an altar of sacrifice. Amen. God was saying to David, to this threshing floor and sacrifice yourself. Sacrifice yourself. And God says to him, I need you to at the altar, give a sacrifice of a burnt offering. A sacrifice is something that you withhold from yourself for the benefit of God. What Timayona when? For the benefit of God. Amen. So when David got to the threshing floor and he had to make a sacrifice, Urania says to him, I will give them to you for free. But David says a very interesting thing. He says, No. I will pay you for this threshing floor. I will pay you for everything you are going to give me. Why? Because I will not give to God a sacrifice that doesn't cost me nothing. I cost the same. You see, when you go before God, you are actually taking out some that may have been working for you all this years. You have to get to a place where you sacrifice your heart and open it and say, Mutimaka, this I do not need. I am leaving it here. Now, this is what I am willing to give to you. It is valuable to me. In my eyes, I think. But to you, because it is not working, I am willing to sacrifice it. It will be bad. sacrifice must cost something in your life. If you are giving to God something that does not take away something out of you, you are wasting your time. You are wasting your time. You must give. Time is valuable to us. That's why when we come here and we give money, it's not nice for him, because we need it. It is not nice. Oh, church, a little tithe. Why? Because we are kaela. But you know what? The word of God calls me to do it. So I'm going to do it. You give it. And you give it. But you give it and nonetheless allow yourself to be cheerful. Because you are giving it to God. If you are letting go of something, I can assure you it will not be in vain. Because those who always give to the Lord, they can bless the tenfold. Amen. They can bless the tenfold. A sacrifice must cost something. Those things don't necessarily change with each other. Those things don't necessarily change. Nda, kini katse na kamu kabulela. Ukama bado mko chuhumu. Ukasa kuzimeli nda. Ukasa ajuili nda. Those things that you think they are working for you, God is saying, sacrifice them for you to move forward with me. Jacob, you will remain Jacob. So long as I'm alive, we will try to offer to Jesus each other. It was not necessary for Jacob to steal the blessing. It was his. From the beginning, it was his. Because it was a way of life, he carried on going. And so long as others are prepared for actual and with deceitfulness, he would never become Israel. He would never be formed by God into a nation. So as long as you are not going to be able to do that, you are not going to be able to do that. Some of us, it's a sense of who we are. Some of us, it's a sense of pride. Some of us, it's a sense of what our marriages do, or what our marriages project, or what our money projects, what our beauty projects. Some of us, it's our money. Amen. Some of us, they give us a sense of who we are. Until you get to that place, sacrifice, and go to God as plain as you are, you'll never succeed. And so I'm dealing with John the Baptist when he speaks about Christ. The book of Matthew chapter 3 verse 12, he says, I'm baptizing you here in the river, turning your old life into the kingdom life. The real action comes next. The main character in this drama, compared to him, I'm a mere stagehand. He will ignite the kingdom life with you. Anyway, the Holy Spirit within you, changing you from the inside out, is going to clean house. He has a winding fork in his hand. And he is going to thresh the wheat from the chaff. And the chaff will eat the wheat. He's going to gather them for his use. And what he doesn't need, he's going to throw into the unquenchable fire. There are things in your life, and God is calling for you. Or separation must take place so that those things which are good, he can gather and use for your benefit. And those things which are bad, they can go into the fire. If you don't do it now, it will not more. Spiritually, the wheat and the bad things, you watch it together. So we can't tell what is what. I don't want to distinguish between the two, because the watching more, the gift of praying in tongues has grown, but the lies has also grown in your life. The gift of interpreting dreams has grown, but the gossip has also grown in your life. There needs to be a separation. You must go to that place of separation and say, Mutimwaka, on this one clear palelo, I am looking unto you, my God. I wronged you by relying on myself. I wronged you by thinking I can do better by myself. Hallelujah. I wronged you. Because unless you do that, the journey is being delayed with God.
The shame is not paid.
You've got to pay something. You've got to pay something. It's a sacrifice. It's a sacrifice. What I like, glory only after the sacrifice has been made. David got his answer. He asked God for forgiveness. God doesn't say I've forgiven you. He says go to that threshing floor. Pride each way. Again, her pride is no joy. We sacrifice at the altar. Only then, when he has done all of that, the word of God says, God spoke to the angel and said to him, retreat well around. You see, when things are bad, and you see some things within you, and you go to that place of separation, don't curse yourself. Don't feel you are losing. It is also a place of answers that God is going to give you. On this and that. God meets you at that very point. He uplifts you as you drop those things he doesn't need. He carries you out and starts giving your blessings and starts answering your prayers because you are willing to sacrifice at the threshing floor for him to beat out Chasadina Keri. One of the word of God says, after Jacob crossed the river, he said, welcome. He never thought the person he was, he could be accepted by his brother because he was a lying, deceitful somebody. But at that very place where he dropped the lying Jacob, where he dropped the deceitful Jacob, where David dropped the prideful David, he gave the David who was fearful of the Lord, he gave the David who knew now the power of God, he gave David, who now knew the sovereignty of God, Jacob gained the acceptance of Esau back. He gained the love of his brother back. Listen, you must go to a place of separation because God is waiting for you there to throw away something so that you can pick up something else and move forward with the journey. You've got to go and separate at the place where God has asked you to go. He says, go to the threshing floor. I want to deal with some issues inside of you. And until you do that, there's never going to be a change in your life. There is never going to be a you. There is never be going to be somebody who can be used by God. It is not a loss for you to throw away those things. It is a gain. As at the threshing floor, the lie answers waiting for you. The lie is God waiting for you. He is waiting for you to allow those things, Genesis, again, to get out of your life. To get out of your life. Oh, oh.